बोल्ट्स, आज हम बोल्ट की बात करेंगे और हाउ द नट इज स्क्रूड ऑन अ बोल्ट एंड व्हाट आर द वेरियस लॉकिंग अरेंजमेंट्स इन अ बोल्ट्स। सो अ बोल्ट कंप्राइजेस ऑफ टू पार्ट्स, अ शैंक एंड अ हेड। Shank is an end for sufficient length so as to effectively engage with a nut. The shape of the head depends upon the purpose for which the bolt is required. So while considering the length of the bolt, the thickness of the head is not taken into account. So this is a generalized form of a bolt, that is hexagonal headed bolt. So, and this is the most common form of a bolt. The head is chamfered at its upper end. This is chamfered. This upper end is chamfered. To prevent the rotation of the bolt while screwing the nut on or off it, the bolt head is held by another when the nut is screwed on it. The dimensions of the bolt head are the same as these of the hexagonal nut, except for the thickness. The head dimensions and the nut dimensions are same, but there is some difference in the thickness, the head thickness, this thickness. So this head thickness is in relation with this diameter, the bolt diameter D. So that is 0.8 times D. Profit. So when it is not possible to hold a bolt head by means of a spanner, the bolt is prevented from rotating by the provision of one of the following. We have to hold the head of the bolt and with the spanner, and then the nut is screwed on it or off it. But if it is not possible to hold the head of the bolt with the help of a spanner, then these are the methods which are used to prevent the rotation of the bolt while screwing the nut on or off it. So one way is by providing a square neck, another one is a pin, another one is by snag. So this is another bolt. This is the square neck which is provided. So and here the head of the bolt is a square. Okay. So this is the head of the bolt, square head, and below it there is a square neck which is provided. This neck fits into the recess, means where the bolt is used there is a recess. So in that recess this part fits, and then the nut is screwed on it, so it prevents the rotation. So this is generally used when the head is to be accommodated in a recess. This recess also is made of a square shape, so that the bolt is prevented from turning when the nut is screwed on or off it. This bolt is commonly used in bearings for the shaft. The bolt head is chamfered at its upper ends. This upper end is chamfered. Thickness of the bolt head varies from 0.8 D to D. Width across the flats is 1.5 D plus 3 mm. So this is the width, 1.5 D plus 3 mm. Cylindrical or cheese headed bolt. So this bolt is used when the space for accommodating the bolt head is comparatively limited, or where the use of a spanner for holding it is to be avoided. Means where we cannot use a spanner or we cannot have a recess. So it is commonly used in the big ends of the connecting. So there is a, and the space where this bolt is to be fitted also contains this hole, space recess over. So this pin fits in that recess. So it prevented the rotation, and the nut is turned on it. These are its dimensions, the head. Cup-headed or round-headed bolt. This is a cup-shaped head. It is provided with a snug forged. This is a snug which is provided. Yes, snug. On the shank, just below the head. It fits into a corresponding recess in the adjacent piece to prevent rotation of the bolt. So this snug is there. So there is a recess in which this nut fits. So it prevents the rotation of this member while screwing a nut on it. And these are the dimensions. This bolt is often provided with a square neck. This is a square neck. T-headed bolt. So this is T-head. The shape is T. So it is used in machine pool tables in which T-slots are cut to accommodate the T-heads. So there are T-slots in the machine bed. So this T portion fits into the T-slots, and then the nut is turned, is put on or off it. So the neck of this bolt also is usually square in the cross-section. So the neck is also square cross-section. The T-headed bolt is often made use of in gland and stuffing box arrangement in the boiler mountings, such as the stop valve, feed check valve, etc. So in that case, the square neck becomes unnecessary, and hence it is not provided. The countershank headed bolt, so where the head of a bolt must not project above the surface of the connected piece. This form of bolt is used. So it may be provided with a snug or a neck of a square cross section. So these bolts are used where we need to have flat surface, okay, such as a box is there which is covered with its cover plate, na? Cover plate humne laga diya. Cover plate ke upar kisi bhi tarah ka projection nahi chahiye. Agar hum koi head wala bolt lagate hain, to projection upar rahega. Hum plain surface chahiye. So we use this countershank headed bolt here. So this is a snug which is used, or we can use a square neck also. This snug hum use nahi kar rahe. So we can use a square neck also. So for this, there is a recess of a square hole. So usme fit ho jayega, and then the nut is screwed on it. Hook bolt. This bolt passes through a hole in one piece only, while the other piece is gripped by the hook-shaped bolt head. It is used when it is not possible to drill a hole in the piece joining the bolt head. Bolt ka jo head hai yahan pe joining, it is not possible to drill a hole. The square neck prevents the rotation of the bolt. Now, hook bolt, there are various options for such as the J-hook. J-hook is there, or U-hook is there. So, say if there is a tin shed, hai, so that contains a pipe, or uske upar chaddar hai. So there is a hole which is drilled in the sheet, and the bolt is taken outward from the hole on the sheet, and then the nut is screwed on it. Headless tapered bolt and IA bolt. So its shank is tapering. So this is the tapering shank, and it has no head. It is used mainly in marine shaft couplings. So that marine shaft couplings, we have understand the design procedure. We have discussed the design procedure of the marine type of couplings. So where this type of bolt is used. This bolt has a this is a headless tapered bolt and I bolt. So this is a I bolt. This bolt has a circular ring of a rectangular cross section at its head, which can be conveniently held to prevent its rotation. So if we hold this, rod can be inserted here, so that will hold it, and then this nut is screwed on it. Lifting I bolt. It is used as an appliance for lifting heavy machines. So some heavy machines contain this eye bolt. So this eye bolt, the purpose of this providing eye bolt is to lift the machine. So heavy appliances are lift using this bolt. So it is screwed inside a threaded hole on the top of the machine directly above its center of gravity. So the bolt is mounted at the center of gravity of the machine lies. So this is used to lift the machines. So this is known as lifting eye bolt. This the head is eye end. Tape bolt or cape screw. So tape bolt or cape screw. So it is a bolt used as a screw that is screwed into a threaded hole in a casting instead of a nut. So nut is not used. These are the two members A and B. And so there is a thread inside the body B and inside the body A. So the bolt is inserted and it is screwed into these bodies. And then instead of a nut, means body, the threaded holes are in the body itself. It is used when it is not possible to accommodate the nut. Means we cannot place the nut, then this then we have to use this. It passes loosely through a clear hole in the piece A adjoining the bolt head and is screwed into a threaded hole in the casting B. So there is a hole here. Now there are two cases. One, dono mein threaded hai aur is body mein thread hai aur is body mein clear hole hai. So this is inserted and then this is screwed in the casting. Frequent insertion or removal of the tape bolt is likely to damage the threads in the casting. So if you frequently screwed it or unscrewed it, then it destroys the whole threaded holes. Owing to this disadvantage, this method of fastening is employed only when parts are not to be disconnected very often. Means for fixing purpose we use this. Tape bolts have various forms of heads similar to those of the set screws shown in the figure. They are used for connecting a cylinder head with a cylinder of an internal combustion engine. Stud bolt or stud. Now there is another terminology, that is the stud bolt or stud. So it consists of only a cylindrical shank. So this is a stud, means it does not have head. While bolt ki hum baat kar rahe hain, the bolt is having a head, while stud is not having a head. It is a cylindrical shank threaded at both ends. This end is threaded and this end is also threaded. The nut end in this nut end end, the nut end end is threaded for length slightly more than the thickness of nut or nuts to be used. So this is the part where nut is to be used. So this length is more than the thickness of the nut. The other end M, called the metal end, this is the metal end, this end is known as the metal end, is threaded for length at least equal to the diameter of the stud. This length, the minimum length of this, is equal to the stud diameter. ये जो stud है, ठीक, इसके diameter के बराबर minimum रहता है. The length of the plain part P, this is the plain part P, between the two ends depends upon the thickness of the piece adjoining the nut. The part which is to be fitted here, यहाँ पर तो fit करना है. The stud is used in place of a bolt where when there is insufficient space to accommodate the bolt head or to avoid use of an unnecessarily long bolt. So studs are commonly used to connect cylinder covers to engine cylinders. So पहले इसको body में fit कर देते हैं, देन अनदर प्लेट इज इंसर्टेड, या जो उसमें होल इसको इंसर्ट किया, फिर यहाँ पर इसको नट लगा दिया. So when a stud is used for connecting a piece to a very thick block, the hole is drilled in that block and then taped. So this part, say this type of studs are used in boiler applications, boiler mountings, and also in the engine parts. The diameter of the drill is equal to the core diameter of the stud. The end of the hole is conical on account of the pointed end of the drill. The depth of the hole is kept at least equal to 1.25 times D. So where D is the diameter of the stud. Then foundation bolts. So these bolts are used for fixing machines to their foundations. This, they are very important bolts. So one type of foundation bolt is I foundation bolt. So simple forms of these bolts can be quickly forced from a mild steel or a wrought iron bar. So this is the material. These bolts are suspended in the hole on there. On the foundation by these bolts. So this is foundation. Since any machine, when works, vibrations are developed. So it is necessary to dump the vibrations, and therefore it is necessary to have proper foundation. So to have proper foundation, these bolts are used. So this is I bolt. This head is turned into I head. The I head, जैसे ये इसमें दिखा हुआ, ये I हेड है, ये आई हेड में कन्वर्ट किया, फिर इसमें एक मेंबर जो है परपेंडिकुलर इंसर्ट किया, सो दिस इज अ मेंबर व्हिच इज इंसर्टेड परपेंडिकुलरली, और इसको फाउंडेशन में जो होल ड्रिल किया वहां पर इसको इंसर्ट किया, और फिर उस होल के अंदर जो है वो सीमेंट कंक्रीट हमने जो है वो डाल दिया उसको मजबूत करने के लिए. सो दिस जब इसमें मशीन का जो बेस है उसको हम यहाँ पर इंसर्ट करेंगे मशीन में जो होल्स है, और उसके बाद में इसको ऐसे नट से टाइट कर देते. सो दिस इज द फाउंडेशन बोर्ड. और जो ये हमारे हाई मास्ट के पिलर्स हैं, वो पिलर्स यदि आपने देखे होंगे तो नीचे फाउंडेशन में जो नंबर ऑफ होल्स आर देयर, या ब्रिज स्ट्रक्चर देख लें, ब्रिज स्ट्रक्चर में भी फाउंडेशन बोर्ड्स आर यूज्ड. अनदर टाइप ऑफ फाउंडेशन बोल्ट इज रेग बोल्ट. दिस इज अ रेग बोल्ट. ये it has its lower part rectangular in cross section. So this is the lower part which is rectangular in cross section. Ye rectangular in cross section part hai, ye lower part, and increasing in width only. Aur width mein increase hua hai, yahan se dekhen to yahan tak hi increasing width mein hua. Its edges are indented. These edges are indented. Ye dekho indented hai is tarah se, aur groove. The bolt is freely suspended in its position in concrete or stone foundation, and the annular space around it is filled with a molten lead or sulfur. Molten lead or sulfur se iske annular space ko ye bhar di jati hai. Ye wali space. This bolt cannot be easily dislodged after it has been grouted. Ek bar yadi isko humne yahan fix kar diya to usko hum dislodge nahi kar sakte. Means we cannot remove it. Levi's bolt. This bolt is fixed in position by inserting a key on the face opposite to the tapering face. So this bolt contain a tapering face. ये tapering face है यहाँ से ये वाली. और इस tapering face के opposite में यहाँ पर एक tapered key ये insert की है. ये key opposite to this face. It can be removed without difficulty by withdrawing the key, which is also tapering. ये जो key है, हम इस bolt को easily, we can separate this bolt easily. इस key को हम remove कर ले, so we can easily remove this. So this is ये concrete है. Quarter foundation bolt. It is used for fixing heavy machines. it has a rectangular slot to receive a quarter C. This is a quarter C. A quarter C. Which is inserted through a wind hole previously kept in the foundation for this purpose. A cast iron washer W provides bearing surface for the quarter. Heavy machine tools are fixed on the foundation by these bolts. So for this bolt is used for the heavy foundation, heavy machines ka jo foundation hai, so karne ke liye this bolts is this quarter bolt foundation is used. Then set screws. These are the screws, these are known as set screws. So it is similar to a tape bolt, but is threaded practically throughout its length. Puri length iski jo hai wo threaded hoti hai. It is used to prevent relative movement between the two pieces. Therefore, it is known as the set screws. ये बॉडी है और दूसरी बॉडी ये है, ये दोनों बॉडी है, इन दोनों का रिलेटिव मूवमेंट प्रिवेंट करना है. सो दिस इज इंसर्टेड. इट इज स्क्रूड इनटू अ टेप्ड होल इन द पीस एडजॉइनिंग द स्क्रू हेड व्हाइल इट्स एंड प्रेसेस ऑन द अदर पीस दिस प्रिवेंटिंग रिलेटिव रोटेशन और स्लाइडिंग. हेड्स ऑफ सेट स्क्रूज एक्सेप्ट दोस व्हिच कैन बी ऑपरेटेड बाय स्पिनर्स और रेंचेस आर प्रोवाइडेड विद screwdriver slots. So this can be used with a spinner, and there are heads which can be which are provided with a screwdriver slots, such as the minus slot is there, plus slot is there, a star slot is there. Yeah. These are the various set screws heads. Okay. So set screws have heads of various forms, hexagonal and square heads are similar to the bolt heads. The other forms of the heads as shown in the figure are here. So round or cup, this is round or cup, or ye minus ka yahan pe slot kata hua hai. So the screwdriver hai with having a minus only. Cylindrical cheese, this is a cylindrical cheese. Then philister. This form is known as the philister form. This is the counter shank, 45 degree. Instrument called instrument screw. Socket. This is a socket. And sixth is socket. This is a socket. ये L and key से खुलते हैं ये वाली socket. Hexagonal है. ये square है. ये L and key लगती है इसमें. स्क्रूड्राइवर नॉर्मल से नहीं होता है. द स्क्वायर हेड इज समटाइम्स मेड ऑफ स्मॉलर साइज. ये स्क्वायर हेड है. द ग्रब स्क्रू इज नो हेड. ये ग्रब स्क्रू है, इसमें हेड नहीं होता. ये स्लॉट कटा होता है माइनस का स्क्रूड्राइवर. एंड दिस लास्ट वन शोज अ कॉलर स्क्रू. सो देयर इज अ कॉलर व्हिच इज प्रोवाइडेड हियर. ये स्क्रू इज देयर. ये हेड इज देयर विद अ स्क्वायर हेड. Width of the slot for this screwdriver in each case is equal to 0.2D plus 0.1, while its depth is equal to this dimension in case of flat top and rounded top. So these are the heads of the set screws. Ends of set screws, the grub screws are made in one of the following shapes. So ये ends जो है इनके set screws का जो end है, ये इनके शेप इस तरह से बनाते हैं. ओवल, कॉनिकल, फ्लैट, कप, हाफ डॉग एंड फुल डॉग. दिस इज हाफ डॉग एंड फुल डॉग. नाउ डिफरेंस बिटवीन अ स्क्रू एंड अ बोल्ट. सो अ स्क्रू इज सिमिलर टू अ बोल्ट. द नेम्स आर ऑफन लूजली इंटरचेंज्ड, दो स्ट्रिक्टली अ बोल्ट इज इक्विप्ड विद अ नट व्हिच इज रोटेटेड टू टाइटन द असेंबली. Bolt is there, so nut is required. Whereas a screw is itself rotated and engages with a threaded or taped hole in a stationary component, such as an engine block casting, या in a wall. Wall पे दीवाल है हमारी, दीवाल पे हमें एक board लगाना है, electric का board है, या TV का panel को fix करना है, So we use screws, not nut bolt. So that's all for today. So this is a brief introduction about the various types of bolts, screws, studs, ये terminologies क्या है और इनके head forms क्या क्या है. नेक्स्ट क्लास में अब इन स्क्रूज थ्रेड्स में या बोल्ट्स नट्स में स्ट्रेसेस कौन कौन से डेवलप होंगे और कैसे हम उसको फोर्स अप्लाई करेंगे, दैट वी विल डिस्कस इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास.